Hey guys, it's day three of vlog week two, and today we worked on finding the code, and lucky for me, I found a sample of a code on the Arduino website, and the code I needed for the servo motor is called a sweep. And basically what the sweep does is it allows the servo motor to go 180 degrees from 0 degrees in motion, and it tells the servo to what position to go to, and basically that's all it does. It'll work with my robot for movement, and that's what will make the robot's like legs or other like functions happen. So I'll get into that. I found the code for it and I'll show that in a second. So here we go. Here is day three, here is the code. I set this up in day two, which I have the video already. Here's the setup of the circuit. It's pretty simple. We didn't need the breadboard at the moment. All we needed was just three hookup wires, servo motor, and then the USB to plug into my laptop. So this is the setup. Without the code, it just makes this weird noise. So we added the code, which the code we found for sweep is right here, and that's where I found the information about like what it does and everything. The 180 degrees is right here. All I did, I opened the code right there, and I went to my Arduino editor. This is my servo motor code, and I copied and pasted it, and here we are, and you can see it's working. You can see it rotating. I'll put something in it to show you. Alright, just for further demonstration. Oh, something else. Okay, hold on, let me set this up. I'll show you in just one second. Alright guys, here is the servo motor in action. I'll hold it as still as possible so you can tell I'm not moving it. You can see the little thing on the inside. It's moving 180 degrees. So you can see the wire moving back and forth. That'll be helpful for the robot. I can envision using this to help my robot legs like move or walk back and forth, you know. And also it's on loop, so it'll just keep going like this. Like it won't stop or anything like that, and I can restart it. So yeah, and that's, I guess, part one of milestone two. Now we'll be working on the ultrasonic sensor next, and the code for that. So I'll check back with you in a bit.